everyone. I'm Colleen Knight. We're here at the Great Outdoors RV in Evans, Colorado, and today I'm going to run you through the ROCKWOOD 2912BS. Kitchen. There's two kind of neat features that's going on right here covering up the sink. You can use this as a drying rack. You can use the other side as a cutting board. Nice stainless steel sink here. And adjustable faucet. So that's super nice. They've also upgraded the oven. It's got a quite a bit thicker griddle top on top here, and they've kind of put this silver top onto everything. It looks quite a bit fancier than it used to, and now you have a really nice window that you can look through as well and check on your food. Spark ignition for the burners as well as the inside of the oven, so super easy access to your oven and your burners. You also have a knife rack back here, so you can put your knives in here, and they're just kind of out of, you know, the way. There's no way your little kids are going to get a hold of them or anything. It's a nice little safety feature back there. We also have an extension for the countertop that's built in, so no more trying to pull the additional countertop and sliding it in. Now all you have to really do is just pull it up and make sure it's locked into place, and you're good to go. Right over here, we have good size fridge freezer. This is both gas and electric. That's a really nice feature. If you have food left over at the end of your camping trip and you unhook from your electricity, it'll just switch to gas for you so you don't end up wasting any food. All right. Right here is a microwave. It's big enough for 11-inch plate. Sometimes these microwaves look kind of small from the front, but when you open them, you can see how deep they are. And they're usually, you know, pretty good size. Definitely big enough. Next, we have the entertainment area right here. TV comes with it. It's just not inside of it right now. You have a ton of extra storage behind there. And it's really accessible. It's easy to get to. Nice long sound bar. Bluetooth ready stereo that also will take DVDs. Down here, we have an extended fireplace. It's an electric fireplace. It can be 750 watts or 1500 watts. We'll heat you out of this area if you want it to. That'll help save on your LP gas if you don't want to be running that for your furnace. So function and a little bit of ambiance as well. Right over here, we have theater seating. This camper's been optioned with the theater seating. You can also option it if you wanted to do an order. You can option it with a trifold sofa so that you can have additional sleeping if you need that. These have heat in them and then a little bit of a massage effect as well. It also lights up at the bottom, which is kind of cool. They come with a couple tray tables, so if you want to sit here in front of the TV and eat your dinner, you can. If you have an iPad or a computer or something, you could set it on the table that comes with it too. They have pull cords, so they recline a little bit. nice and comfy little space to enjoy TV and if it's raining outside. Otherwise, you should be outside. Here's your dinette, nice and comfy for four people. This will also turn into a bed. We're going to show you that in just a second. It has an easy adjust table, so you basically just press the button and the table moves, kind of swivels down and in. So you're not messing around with pulling legs off and then, you know, trying to fit them in the holes. This is a much easier, simpler way to do it.
So I'll show it, okay? That's it.
Okay, you all just saw how easy Ock did that. That's what I was talking about without having to pull those legs out. It just makes the whole process a lot easier. So this would just make into your extra bed if you need be. It's pretty long. You could probably fit, definitely you could fit two kids in there and probably two adults as well. All right, we're going to go over here and take a quick look at the storage. The storage in this unit is pretty intense. There's a lot of it. So this is super deep. I don't know if you can, if that's coming through on the video, but there's a lot of room in there. There's also two drawers here. This is a good spot for shoes, and you'll also have another kick spot for shoes over here. So that's super nice. That's kind of rare. You don't always see a spot for shoes in campers. You also have two under the dinette storage, one door here, and then one pull out right here. And then over by the door, you have even more. A couple coat racks. If you wanted to remove those, you could. Super nice spot for hanging your coats. And then the shoes again. It's a big deal. Right here is where your control panel is. So you would control all of your slides and your awning from right here. Your lights as well. Your Wi-Fi booster. This has a Wi-Fi ranger on it, so it'll be a lot easier to pick up Wi-Fi in this unit than a regular camper. You also have kind of your checks over here. These buttons here will tell you how charged your battery is or how full your freshwater, gray water, black water tanks are. All right, let's check out this bathroom. We're going to start over here, and in the walk-in closet, you'll have four nice shelves over there. On the right side, we have a washer-dryer hookup, and what's really good about this area is that it's set up in case you don't want to have the washer and dryer. You still have two really good spots to hang clothes, so none of that space is going to end up wasted. Behind the toilet here, we have a nice large storage cabinet as well. This camper has so much storage in it, it's almost unreal. So right here you have your nice little medicine cabinet. This 360 siphon sticker means that this camper is set up so that all of the odors from the bathroom come up through the roof, so none of them go over your door or through the top of your door. Little air storage area down here as well. In the corner shower, Rockwood has just added the shower miser to their units. What this does is it recirculates your water to your hot water heater until it's warm. When your water is warm and usable, this becomes kind of whitish clear. You switch the valve up and you have access to your water. That will save you anywhere between a quarter to a third of your fresh water simply because you're not washing it and wasting it down the drain while you're waiting for it to get warm. Right above here, we have a max air fan. It also has a cover on it. These fans will turn 920 cubic feet of air per minute. Comes out to be about a 10 mile an hour breeze you can have running through your coach for you. Just a couple quick things to finish up in here in the bathroom. Here's a very good size sink. Hot, cold, of course. Down here you have a heat duct, so your bathroom's going to stay nice and cozy. And then you also have ducted AC vents in here if you like it on the cooler side. All right, come this way and I will show you the best thing about this camper. This front bedroom is absolutely amazing. You have a ton of floor space, tons of room to get dressed, to change your clothes, which everybody knows can be kind of difficult in a camper sometimes. Again, with the storage, just an unbelievable amount of storage in here. I was almost speechless there for a couple seconds. Right over here, you have a great sitting area. And then throughout the coach, you also have day-night shades all combined into one, which is a feature that I really, really like. So if it's nighttime and you want to block everything out, or if it's daytime and you're trying to sleep, you just run them down like that, and then they'll all run up together if you want to utilize the large front window. This is a really nice large front window. Here we have the bed. The bed is on the slide, and that of course always opens up the bedroom. I pulled the wrong thing up. Lots of storage underneath, and we'll get a little peek of that from the outside when we do around the outside as well. Two nice pull drawers. The handle is another big feature, as everyone knows who owns a camper. Sometimes when you put the bed down, it'll slam on you. So having this little handle right here is a nice little add-on. More cabinets, overhead cabinetry up through here, all the way to the end of the coach. This is super deep, deeper than what you would initially think. And then you have two deep, deep cabinets on the side as well. Both of these have hang bars on the inside, so you could also hang your clothes here as well. Okay, right here we have phone chargers and a 12-volt charging station as well. 110 plug-ins. Over here you have a TV backer, so if you wanted to add an additional TV into your coach, this is where you would put your mounting, right here. You're already pre-wired for cable and satellite and your plug-in, so you're, you know, super set up. Rockwood always is really good about putting stuff where it needs to be placed, so you're all set there and ready to go for a second TV if you want one. You're also all set and ready to go to add a second AC if you would like one. Right here is where you would put your sensor that would kick on your AC for you. This is where the AC would go. It's already pre-wired, so you'll save on labor. Basically, it's just the quick installation of the second AC. Let's go on outside and we'll take a peek at everything this has to offer on the outside of the coach. Right here, we are pre-wired for solar, so if you wanted to buy some portable solar panels, all you have to do is plug them in right under here. And that's not opening for me, but you guys get the idea. Right next door to the solar prep is a very large pass-through storage. This is underneath that seat in that front bedroom. Lots of room for goodies. Right above here is our awning. This is a 21-foot awning. It's all lit up with LEDs underneath. Here we have these nice stairs, super easy to run. Basically, all you do is pick them up. They fold up inside the door. When you get to your campsite, you just pull them down there. They have a little spring assist inside of them, so it's super easy to use. Large grab assist handle, nice, strong, sturdy, very helpful. Next to that, we have our 6-gallon hot water heater. This hot water heater has a 16.2 gallon recuperation. What that means is after you have exhausted your first 6 gallons, you can have 16.2 gallons of hot water every hour from this guy right here. Here is your outside prep table. All Rockwoods will come with an outside prep table and an outside grill. So if you come outside and you have like a dish of marinated meat or vegetables or whatever, you actually have a spot to set it down on before you would go ahead and grill it, which would be placed right here. This is an outside kitchen area. Nice, large refrigerator, outside refrigerator. That'll fit a lot of beer. That's everyone's beer fridge. Right here, you have a 2-burner stovetop. So that's super nice. This, of course, holds it up right here and kind of blocks the wind for you. There are two quick connect LPs. One is for this one, for the grill, and then one is for your burner. So you're set up really nice here for some outside cooking and grilling as well. You have a nice size cabinet to keep your outside cooking supplies if you want to, a nice size shelf, and then plug in. You could even put your coffee maker or your toaster or whatever out here if you want to do breakfast outside. Everybody's really big on cooking their bacon outside so that you don't get that grease on the inside of your coach. Let's go. Well, we can talk about the axles. The axles here are Toraflex axles. They come with a 10-year warranty on them, which is almost unheard of in the RV industry to get a 10-year warranty on your axles. It's very, very good. All right, we have equipped this Rockwood with a back ladder for you, so easy roof access. The roof is 100% walkable, and it comes with a 12-year warranty on it, 12-year part warranty on it. More controls for your jacks, for your back jacks right there. Right here is what would look like a storage door, but it's actually access to your water pump and your filter. This will make winterization super easy because your access is right here. Very accessible. You have a back light, you have your winterization antifreeze port for you, and then your city water connection. This is an outside shower. It will have hot and cold access with a little shower head. Full size spare, hard covered, a nice protection for that. Over here you have your black tank flush on the outside of your coach, super handy, makes flushing out that black tank a lot easier than having to go in through your bathroom. 50 amp service, your cable satellite hookup for you, and then your valves under here. This guy has heated holding tanks and an enclosed underbelly, and all of the elbows are heated as well. So a little added heat for all of your plumbing. Right over here, we have some more storage. That's that door that I opened underneath the dinette. Another thing to note is that Rockwood uses frameless windows. That's a huge benefit because anytime there's not rubber around your window, the sun doesn't have the opportunity to kind of chew at it. So that's really helpful and will elongate the life of your coach. Another large storage area again. This is underneath the bed. We kind of peeked at it inside when I pulled the bed up. If you haven't noticed, all of the storage doors are held up by magnets. There's no clips to fumble with. Just everything is super easy to utilize on this coach. This is just the other side of that pass-through storage. I'm gonna close this up. And I think 2 30-pound tanks, that's another big benefit. Instead of a combined 20, you have a combined 60. That's super nice. Nice power tongue jack. Docking station, lights, probably a nice LED setup right here. You also have a battery disconnect. They used to be on the inside of coaches and kind of scattered here and there. Now Rockwoods are all generally right up front. One of the major decisions you have to make when purchasing a coach is you have to find a coach that your truck or your tow vehicle can pull. This guy right here comes in at 7,732 pounds dry. What that means is that is the base weight without anything, none of your gear, none of your water, nothing added to it. Your GVWR is the combined loaded weight. Basically how much weight the axles on the coach can carry. This comes in at 9,752 pounds. So this is the number that you want to make sure that your tow vehicle can pull. That is your deciding number right there. Thank you guys for joining us as we did the walkthrough on the 2912BS Rockwood. My name again is Colleen Knight. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to call us at 970-313-4337. You can also reach me directly at Colleen@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you want to subscribe and see more videos, please hit that button. And hopefully we'll see you at the next video. Have a great day. Bye-bye.